Was that when man was in an apprentice? Or working for what? £7.50 a day? £7.50 a day? Sorry, £7.50 an hour, you know? No, what am I talking about? £5 an hour. What am I talking about? £7.50 would have been a luxury per hour. £5 an hour. Yeah? Man, I'm working in, remember, this is just Tottenham, you know? Yeah? Working in Broadwater Farm. Yeah, imagine having to go to a Broadwater Farm estate in the morning. Yeah? To sign in. Yeah? You may sign in, you might not sign on in Broadwater Farm's a dangerous area. Working in them nasty tower blocks in Broadwater Farm. Yeah? Having to ride around with man that you don't really like all day long. Yeah? Listening to him chat shit and then you have to do all the shit jobs. Can you believe, yeah, like, on my fourth day being an apprentice, I fell out with the man that I was working with, yeah? On my first day when I was an apprentice, I met some guy, yeah? Some guy called Andy, yeah? Big guy, yeah? Tall, and he was built, yeah? He weren't hench or nothing like that. He weren't muscular, but, yeah. He had some weight on him, yeah? It would take more than a stiff breeze to blow him down, yeah? I'll tell you that now. He's one of them people that come across really like meek and weak and timid, yeah? Quote unquote, gentle giant type of person or whatever, innit? So when I first met him, I thought to myself, like, I can acknowledge that there's certain people in this world, you know, they're weak characters, right? You can push them over or whatever, innit? Yeah? So as soon as I observed him, like, you know, he's all one of them type of man there. So as soon as I observed him, I knew, okay, this guy is like a pushover, innit? Not that I'm gonna take advantage of him or anything like that, car. I'm not a bully. Yeah? If you see someone and you observe someone that has weak body language and you can acknowledge that, oh, okay, this person is a weaker character than me, I could potentially push them over. Irrespective of age, I was 19 and he was well into his 30s, but irrespective of age, right? If you take advantage of that, because you know, okay, yeah, I can push this person over because obviously they're a weaker character than me. You are a bully. Yeah, if you act on it, sorry. If you act on it, you are a bully. Yeah, now, if you just acknowledge it, you just acknowledge it. Remember, I got in the van with him for the first time, you know, on the first day, right? And this guy's all acting all weak and meek and, yeah, he's a pussy, basically, isn't he? Let's not, yeah? He ain't PC out here, isn't he? Yeah, he's a pussy, yeah? That was in the office amongst managers and that. As soon as we jumped in the work van, my man changed, yeah? Like, his whole persona, everything, yeah, it changed. Right? It was almost like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. On one hand, you know, like he's a weak, meek character and he's a pussy, innit? But on the other hand, like when it's just him and myself in the work van, he has more of an aggressive nature, innit? So I clocked, I was like, rah. But anyway, yeah, he didn't say nothing bad, do nothing. Like I just observed the body language, like the shift in the, yeah, in the mannerisms or whatever it is. I'm like, all right, cool. Boom. Working with my man now, yeah. My first job. Any of you lot know Wood Green, yeah? There's one road called Gladstone Avenue, yeah? Off of Noel Park Estate. Yeah, Gladstone Avenue takes you to Wood Green High Street, yeah? And my first job with him, first job on the day, we went to some Somalian people's house. And all the problem was, we needed to change a light switch. And a pendant, yeah? So a pendant is the cord that hangs from the ceiling and you put a light over it, that's a pendant, yeah? Boom. Gone to smiling people's house now. Yeah, boom, 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 this is what we're gonna do, innit, yeah? We've gone back to the van now, innit, yeah? To get the tools and that, yeah? Remember, if you just joined the live stream now, yeah? The guy that I was working with, this guy is 6'3", 6'4", and he's a big guy. He's not hench or nothing like that. You know, let me close this window, car. I noticed when I watch the playbacks, when the cars are driving past, sometimes a bit too loud and that, isn't it? So anyway, this guy's a big guy, yeah? 6'4", and he's, yeah? Not hench, but, you know, he's got some weight on him, yeah? He ain't weak, yeah, physically, yeah? We've gone back to the work van to get the tools and the material, yeah? One pendant, one light switch, yeah? Featherweight items, yeah? Boom! He goes and gets his big toolbox out and he gets his ladder out. Yeah. He's like, yeah, take the toolbox and the ladder. So I'm like, all right, cool. So I'm carrying this heavy toolbox and this heavy ladder, and he's just carrying a switch and a pendant. Right? So I'm like, all right, cool, innit? Boom, 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 boom. So we've done the job, whatever, innit? Yeah. I can't even remember the rest of the day, innit? Yeah. So I've worked with him for a couple of days now, and I've gone home after work, and I remember I was sitting down at the kitchen table. My mum was there, my stepfather and my mum's closest friend was there. We're talking, whatever, innit? And they probably asked me, oh, how's work going, innit? It's a new job, innit? First week at this job, innit? And boom. They're like, how's work going? I was like, you know what? I feel like I'm getting taken advantage of, yeah, at work. So like, all right, what's going on? I said, the guy that I work with, yeah, he's a big guy, yeah? And I don't feel like he's splitting the physical load, yeah, fairly. Like, what do you mean? Well, I'm carrying his toolbox and his ladder, and he's just carrying a little switch and a pendant on. He's just carrying a switch and a pendant, right? These items don't weigh jack shit, yeah? So I'm feeling like my man's taking advantage of me or whatever, yeah? So my mum and her closest friend, with being women and their mothers, so their maternal instincts kicked in. They're like, no, that's not right. How dare he take advantage of you, blah, blah, blah. So my stepfather said, nah, that's kind of how it goes, isn't it? Yeah? The apprentice is kind of like the dog's body, as they call it. Yeah, you basically have to do all the shit jobs, isn't it? Yeah? But I ain't really listening to that. I'm thinking, like, I'm more on what my mum and my mum's close friend saying, it like, because I'm feeling it. I'm feeling like I'm getting taken advantage of, isn't it? Yeah. Now, well, quite a nice here, yeah. Anyway, I'm feeling like, yeah, you know, I'm getting taken advantage of, whatever, isn't it? Yeah. So remember, they're just hearing the story, what I'm saying to them. Yeah. I'm in it. Yeah. I'm the one that's carrying it. I feel, you know, I feel the vibe and stuff in it. So I'm feeling like I'm getting taken advantage of, isn't it? Yeah. Ooh. So I thought to myself, you know what? I ain't having this. Yeah. I think it was like Wednesday night. Yeah. Boom. Thursday come. Next day. Yeah. I said, I'm going to pull him up. Yeah. I said, I'm going to pull him up. Yeah. Anyway, we're driving in the work van now, and we stop off at some traffic lights. Yeah. And this is before we were on our way to the first job. Yeah. First electrical job of the day. Yeah. Pulled up to the traffic lights, innit? I thought, you know what, this is the best time to pull him up. I've got his full attention, yeah? I turn to my right, obviously he's the driver, yeah? So I'm in the left-hand seat, I'm in the passenger seat. I turn to my right and I said to him, from now on, you carry your own tools. He said, what? I said, from now on, you carry your own tools. He said, right, that's it. My man spun the van around in the middle of the road, you know? Like, as the traffic lights have gone green, he's just decided to do basically a U-turn, spin the van around in the road, the car almost hit his car, whatever, innit? And yeah, he drove me back to one of the managers and said, yeah, I can't work with this young man. Yeah, I can't work with him. He don't want to carry the tools and stuff like that. One of the managers come out of the cafe. They want to hear his side of the story first, obviously. Yeah. So he spoke to my man or whatever, innit? Yeah, and he said, yeah, you know, he's refusing to carry my tools and stuff like that. Then my managers approached me and said, listen, yeah, you're the apprentice. You're supposed to carry all the tools. I said, no, I don't go like that. Yeah, listen, I'm Jelani. No, I'm not Donkey from Shrek. Yeah, I'm not carrying all a man's heavy tools. And yet still he's carrying some little items and that, innit? Yeah? So I said, I'm not having it. So anyway, man fucked up that relationship. Yeah, that workmanship with him. And from there at my workplace, it was a downward spiral. Like, I was falling out with man after man after man. That happened during my first week on my fourth day at work. During my second week, I think it was on Friday, I had a fight with a man. I ended up punching a man in the head because I ain't gonna go too much to story, but a man threw some piece of wood at myself and my other work colleagues, and I went to confront him about it, and he started getting rude. So yeah. We end up in a little tussle, and I end up punching him in his head and that. And yeah, from there, I just had one bad relationship throughout the workplace. Imagine, after I had that little tussle with the guy, there's a crowd of people around, obviously. They broke up the fight or whatever. He said, everyone in this workplace thinks you're a fucking wanker. Yeah. So basically, one thing I gathered as well, right? One thing that was brought to my attention, because obviously I'm from the street, innit? Yeah. No. What go on, Jarena? Yeah. No. I didn't punch the guy who was taking advantage of me. This is someone else. Yeah, this is, so I'm falling out with people, innit? Yeah. But anyway, this is someone else. Yeah. A man threw a piece of wood at myself and my work colleagues, and I went to confront him, and then he was, you know, disrespectful. He swore at me, and I don't like people swearing at me. So anyway, we got into a little tussle, whatever, innit? Cool. But yeah, he said one statement. He said, everyone in this workplace thinks you're a fucking wanker. Because one thing I realized, because obviously I'm from the street, so it's the first time I've ever had a job. Yeah. I don't know about all of this. I don't know about all of this gossiping and talking this and that. One thing I realized at work, yeah, is that grown men, like grown man, you know, grown man, yeah, gossip like women. Yeah. They talk about people behind their back like women. Like, this is alien to me. I don't really understand this type of. But yeah, you got grown men, right? And this is the thing. This is what I realized about work as well. Because remember, I'm 19 at this stage, yeah? These men are not all of them are really men. They're just boys that have matured. Do you get me? They're just boys that have grown old, but they haven't, you know, wise up, if you want to call it that, innit? Yeah? But yeah, these are grown men, but they're acting like little kids, gossiping and that, and yeah. Nobody liked me in my workplace when I was an apprentice, because me, I'm a type of man, I'm not interested in socializing with people or getting to know people or being anyone's friend. So when I came to the workplace, nobody liked me. Yeah. It's not just because of the incident I had with obviously the guy that I was working with, and I had a little tussle with a man the next week. Me, I came into the workplace and I'm just like, yeah. I don't want to talk to no. I'm not interested in talking to nobody, innit? Yeah, at first, innit? Yeah, like me, I'm some man. I'll just sit back and just observe, man, and yeah, whatever, innit? Yeah, I ain't trying to come in, and because a lot of people, they, it's mainly like maybe they're anxious or whatever, innit? Yeah, they want to, you know, be friends with everyone because they just want to try and fit in. They don't want to feel like an outcast or alone or nothing like me. I'm the complete opposite, innit? I just sit back and just relax. So. It was only years afterwards, one of my Asian work colleagues, he's a big man, yeah? He's all my mom's age, whatever, innit, yeah? I was doing some work at his house as a private job. And he said, yeah, you know when you first came to the workplace, yeah? All the white people, yeah? The white people at your workplace, they thought you was racist, you know? And the black people thought you was better than them. I said, oh my bumper God, no. So basically the impression, because I was a very reserved person and I used to just, yeah, I didn't really mix with no one or nothing like that, right? The white people thought I was racist, yeah, because I didn't want to mix with them, and the black people thought I was better than them. Yeah. Like, really, is that really possible? Yeah, you can have a man who thinks he's better than white people and better than black people and he don't want to mix with white people or whatever. Like, come on, man. So yeah, yeah, I was a rebel at my workplace. I was a rebel at my workplace, home to Harringay, man. I ended up getting fired from there anyway, because obviously I used to just do what I wanted. Literally, I was like a law unto myself. I was like the Irish. I used to just do what I want. But yeah, it was a good job. It was a good job still. A good job still. Let me just put a few people's names in the comment box, yeah?